This video, I'll walk you through the setup and design of a planted shrimp display aquarium. Hi everyone, it's Ray from RW Aquariums, part 2 of Project Caradina, Tank Setup. For this project, I stopped by my friends at April's Aquarium and picked up a beautiful rimless 7-gallon aquarium by Aquatop. This aquarium in particular uses low iron glass, which when paired up with its clear silicone, creates an illusion of a seamless floating object on display. First, I apply the privacy film to the back of the aquarium. As you will see later on, the fuzzy background adds an illusion of layers and depth to the aquarium and aquascape. Place the leveling mat included with all rimless tanks to your stand to eliminate pressure points on the aquarium by removing imperfections of the stand top. This will reduce the likelihood of your tank cracking and leaking, giving you an entirely new type of water feature you might not want. Once the aquarium is in place, we will add our 60cm Chihiro's A-Series light. During this setup, we will be using the light at 100% power, but to adjust to 20% after the setup is complete to discourage algae growth in the tank. The substrate I'm using in this project is ADA Amazonia. It's been aging in a bucket of water for over 2 months to leach out the ammonia. Other substrates, such as Tropica, don't require this process as it doesn't leach ammonia as much. Carefully place the substrate into the aquarium. Create a gentle slope from front to back for added depth perception. The general rule is to have approximately 1 to 2 inches of substrate in the front and 2 to 4 inches in the back, depending on your design. It is a good idea to remember that the deeper the substrate, the easier it is to add the plants. I will be filling the aquarium with RODI water, and as you can see in my excitement, I added the water too quickly, causing the water to cloud up. A proper technique is to pour the water slowly over a plate or a plastic bag, which spreads the water evenly over the substrate. If you decide to scape your tank dry, a bag or a plate before adding the water will lessen the damage done to your hard work. The mud soup will clear in a few hours thanks to our sponge filter. I will be adding an aged dual sponge filter that's been seeded from my other aquarium for over 6 weeks. You can use a hang-on back filter or a canister, but I find that a sponge filter is more ideal for shrimp due to the low water flow they create. Shrimp also tend to hang out at the sponges as well. After an hour, you'll notice a big difference in the water clarity already. After 4 hours, the water is clear. I've tested the water to be at 15 part per million TDS, and remineralizing to 130 part per million TDS with SL Aqua's Blue Wizard. It's time to aquascape! For this project, I'll be creating a simple triangle layout from high left to low right, using the rule of thirds to create focal points to the top and the bottom of the hill. I've decided to use a beautiful piece of spiderwood and added a second piece to complete my hardscape composition, using the sponge filter to help prop up the wood. I will start with Trident Java Fern on the wood, a classic look that aquascapes use with this epiphyte plant. Then using these high quality ADA pincettes, I will add Subjetaria, a medium grass-like plant to add depth to the middle layer. Blixa japonica is added behind the Sagittaria for a layered grass effect. Monte Carlo is a nice, slower growing carpeting plant that I'll add to the foreground right corner. It will create a visually stunning field. I will sprinkle some Anubias and Buca Philandra throughout to add more layers in this design. Adding some more Hydrocotyle to fill out the midground, it will have a sweeping effect over the aquascape. Voila! The initial planting and design of this aquascape is complete. The plants I've chosen to work with will grow and thrive in a low-tech plant shrimp display aquarium. There are a few other personal choices of plants that will also work. Since we used an aged sponge filter, this aquarium is ready for shrimp. If you don't have an aged sponge filter, you would have to cycle the aquarium to be biologically ready. Usually it takes about 3 to 6 weeks. I'll be letting the plants in the aquarium mature a little bit before introducing shrimp. Next, we will have to decide which type of Caradina shrimps to add to the scape. Which type of Caradina species of shrimp would you like to see in this planted display aquarium? Let us know in the comments below which type of shrimp you would add. Don't forget to like and subscribe!